an international agreement, okay, that have been approved by the United Nations, which countries can adopt to. And if you want to use, you only incorporate them into your laws, and then you use it, so long as you are a member of the United Nations. Remember that not all the countries in the world are members of the United Nations, but majority, over 90% of them are part of the United Nations. So take note of that. So the convention simply means international agreements, sanctioned or designed by the United Nations, okay, for regulating trade or transportation globally. All right, now the United Nations Convention on International Multimodal Transports. And again, one word also I want you to understand. What is international? What do you understand by the word international? Yes, anybody? I want volunteers. Normally, I like people volunteering than to call people. Yes?
Two or more countries that are involved.
Good. What is international? It means it is what? Between or amongst countries. It can be two or more. Okay? So the United Nations Convention on International Multimodal Transport of Goods, which is also called MT, which is yet to come into force, I'll explain, defines international multimodal transport as a means of moving goods door to door internationally under a single liability system, leading to lower delivery costs. Now, this is what it means. The convention says that international multimodal transport means that the goods are being moved from door to door. Door to door simply means that goods are moved from the place of receipt, maybe your warehouse in Ghana, to somebody's factory in Durban in South Africa. That one is what? Door to door. From my door to your door. And then you also have port-to-port transportation. Port-to-port is simply moving goods from one port to another port. You begin from one port and then ends at what? Another port. But door-to-door means that you go further beyond what? The ports. Go from the initial, place of receipt to the final destination. So the UN Convention on International Multimodal Transport defines international multimodal transport as means of moving goods door to door internationally. That means the goods are in one country, maybe from a factory in one country to a warehouse in another country. Okay? As a means of moving goods door to door internationally under a single liability. Single liability means that only one operator is what? Is handling it. Okay, so the operator is responsible for anything that happens to the goods. I can take your goods from here and take it to, I can take your goods from Tema here, let me take your goods from Kumasi, okay? So, I have my Ghana map over there. I did job with you so I can sketch. I'm not an artist, okay? And then the goods are maybe going to, let's say, Johannesburg. So this is Kumasi here, okay? And then this is Johannesburg. Right. You are giving me your goods, okay? But there is no direct link from Kumasi to Johannesburg because Kumasi is not yet an international airport. I hope you understand that. So, what I may do is that I may decide to move the goods from here to Tema, okay? This is Tema. And then from Tema to maybe Durban. Durban is also in South Africa, okay? And then Durban towards Johannesburg. Okay? So, between Kumasi and Tema, I will use road, which is track or something, all right? And then between Tema and Devon, I will use the sea transportation, okay? Sea transport, water transport, 11 from Johannesburg to from Durban to Johannesburg, I can use what rail. This is a typical multimodal transportation if it is being organized by one operator. I hope you understand that. So what the United Nations Convention is saying is that international multimodal transport, this is international multimodal transport, because it spans between countries, Ghana, and then through to South Africa. You know, this passage, this areas are in South Africa. And then it is from door to door because it is from Kumasi. What to port means that it is from Tema to what? Durban. Because Tema is a port, sea port, and then Durban is also a sea port. Are you with me? So this one, you will need a pre-carriage, another means of transport to move it from here to the ports. And then the sea transport will take over from Tema to Durban, and then the rail transport will be running it. So the international multimodal transport is defined as a means of moving goods door to door. So this is from one door. Are you with me? This could be a warehouse, or somebody's factory, or somebody's home. Okay? Two, another person's door, which probably is a factory, a warehouse, his home, or whatever it is. Okay? So that's the meaning of international multimodal transport. It only qualifies to be international multimodal transport when the whole chain is handled by one operator. You get there, you understand it better. The operator is called multimodal transport operator. He is a freight forwarder who has advanced, okay, has international links, and can move goods from any part of the world to another part. You have local freight forwarders, clearages. When you arrive at the airport in Kotoka, they will come to you and say, if you have anything, I want to clear it for you. They don't go anywhere, they are only in Ghana. But somebody is in Tama here, you can move goods from Tamale to even Sydney in Australia. That's the multimodal transport operator. I hope you are following. Alright, so international multimodal transport is therefore an activity that spans national frontiers. National frontiers means national boundaries. Okay? Any question before we move on to the next page? If you don't understand anything, feel free and ask me. Okay? Once you are not late, I'll answer you. If you are late, you don't ask me. You sit down and suffer. Can I go ahead? Alright. Those of you who are late, don't worry. I'm going to give you the whole of this, the lecture notes on Thursday. Listen and understand. So that when you are revising, it will not be difficult for you. Right? The key to modern multimodal transport is unitization. Okay? This is the consolidation together of numerous smaller packages into a unit, which that can be handled throughout the journey into one piece. Let me give you an example. When you see a container, okay, let's say this is a container on a truck. Okay, so this is a container. So this container that you see can be either for international trade, a container is normally of 20 footer length or 40 footer length. There are other lengths for other purposes. But for international trade, we only use 20-footer container. 20-footer, you're talking about the length of the container. This is what we call the 20-footer container. 40-footer, or if it's a smaller one, a 20-footer. It means that the length is just 40 or 20. This is for international trade. Good. Now, anytime you see a container like this, what do you see? You see the whole thing as what? One bulk, unit. Okay? But when you open the container, what do you see? Various boxes, small boxes, packed inside the container. Okay? Yes. There are ties. You see. So, once it is closed, you see the whole thing as one unit. Okay? But once you open it, you see what? So many boxes in it. So, we are seeing the unitization It means that they have unitized these small boxes, okay, to form a unit. Unit means one. Okay? So what we are saying is that the key to multimodal transport is unitization. It means that multimodal transport has become possible because of the fact that you can put smaller packages together to form one big unit, and that unit can be carried as one unit, and it can be moved from one mode of transport to another. The same container that you see on the truck can be placed on a rail chassis. It can also be placed on what? The sea vessel, a ship. I hope you understand that. So that it makes it very easy moving it from what? One mode of transport to another. So that it does not even waste time when you are moving, when you are changing the modes. So we are saying that the key to modern multimodal transport is unitization. And the definition of unitization is that it is a consolidation together of numerous smaller packages, okay, into a unit that can be handled throughout the journey as what? One piece. Okay? So they lift it, a machine lifts it up and puts it in the truck or in the rail chassis or in the ship vessel, and then it moves. Once it gets to the final destination, it changes the mode. They only lift it and put it on another mode, and then it moves. Which means that multimodal transport has become more convenient by the process of unitization. Right. The standard form of unitized through freight transport is the freight container, which I've already spoken about over here. And the plane goes to be packed into the container, which as a single unit may be transferred easily between road, rail, sea, but normally air does not. It's not always possible to add air here. Because see, the container that we use on the road, rail, and the sea is not the same container we put on the aircraft. They have their own special containers. We have to remove the goods from that sea container and put them in the aircraft containers before it goes. So normally the same container can be used on the road, rail, and the sea, but not always on the air. I hope you are following me.